Have you considered giving up on Firefox due to its recent changes? Or maybe you think that's overblown and you're just looking for a secondary browser. You're in the right place. I'm gonna show you 8 top Firefox alternatives, and the goal is to help you find something that connects with you and what you need. These are picked by the community, split in half between 4 Firefox-based browsers, so they're using Firefox as code, and 4 non-Firefox-based browsers using different browser engines. Now, to kind of help us see how each browser compares to Firefox, I put together 5 general things that people might expect from Firefox, one of which is being open source, the second is being user-first, is the common previous association, for some still is, the third, it's privacy and security respecting, the fourth is it's customizable, and fifth is it has strong community values. Let's dive right into it with LibreWolf. So LibreWolf is a fork of Firefox by the community, and it is open source, and I would say it is very much so user first. It's built by passionate devs who have consistently demonstrated they want to build a user first browser. They strip the telemetry, they build their own private search so it doesn't default to Google, it comes with uBlock Origin out of the box, and it has some really nice hardening that normally you'd have to do yourself. What LibreWolf does really well is it maintains a lot of the usability of regular Firefox while adding extra privacy and security. So open source, yes. User first, yes. Privacy and security, better than Firefox. And as for customization, it's the same as Firefox. You're still gonna have Firefox extensions, themes, and features, which should work just as they previously worked on Firefox. As for the community, I'd say it's small but passionate. They're on Matrix, Reddit, Lemmy, and Mastodon, so they support federated open source services, and they're heavily involved in the Fediverse, which I think is fantastic. I think LibreWolf is a fantastic alternative to Firefox if you want something that's like an un-Mozilla version of Firefox with actual improvements in addition to it. The main issue with LibreWolf you need to be aware of is it doesn't have automatic updates without a package manager. So if you're using just the default installation on Windows or on Mac OS, you're gonna have to get updates manually. The next browser is making waves and is pretty new, and it's Zen Browser. It is Firefox-based, and it is open source. Now, user first, I'd say absolutely. The entire browser's purpose is to be a more modern Arc-style version of Firefox, which, as you can tell, is really the focus and I think the main thing they're going after here. Now, the main issue with Zen in terms of the user experience is there's no DRM on Windows and Mac OS, which will prevent you from using almost any streaming service. It's also still in beta. In terms of privacy and security, they do say there's true privacy, but I would probably overall say it's mid if I had to give a word for it. I want to make it clear that Zen respects your privacy decently enough, but it is not strictly a privacy browser. As it's Firefox-based, you can surely install uBlock Origin and harden the browser a fair amount, but its core focus is not maximum privacy and security. Rather, I would say it's usability first, with good enough privacy and security for most people. Customization is hard to cover because in some ways it has more customization options that are not easy to do on Firefox, like vertical tabs and all these cool features that they showcase on their website, so you can't really do those easily on regular Firefox. On the other hand, horizontal tabs will likely be phased out, so you can't even get horizontal tabs on this at some point. But ultimately, it's Firefox-based, so you probably won't find anything too different, and most things you can do in Firefox, you should be able to replicate in Zen. And of course, we have the community, and you can tell from the contributors page here, crazy passionate community, very large size, their Discord servers close to like 20,000 members. Nothing gets people riled up like vertical tabs apparently nowadays. I actually don't like them, but a lot of people like them, and so this is definitely an option to consider that is not Firefox, but is Firefox-based and still respects a lot of the values of Firefox. Next browser is Mullvad Browser. Yes, from the VPN company, Mullvad VPN. This might sound sketchy, but Mullvad actually is all open source, extremely good reputation, and this is a genuinely great browser. It's open source, of course, it is Firefox-based, and in terms of being user-first, I think they do what they can. This is a privacy-focused browser that makes a ton of usability sacrifices to make it privacy-first. This video is recorded in Mullvad, and a small example, as you can see on the edge of the screen, there's the letterboxing. Every website you access will actually be a little little bit smaller to prevent you from fingerprinting, and all data is wiped on exit. So you literally can't really stay logged into websites when you leave the browser. In terms of privacy and security, again, extremely high. This is actually co-developed with the Tor project. The official Tor people, they co-developed this with Mullvad, and it uses many of Tor's mitigations to help protect you. Now, the fourth focus is customization, and I have no issue calling it bad. Hear me out. You can customize Mullvad because it is Firefox-based. You can do everything in Mullvad as you would do in Firefox, but you're completely destroying the point of the browser. Even Mullvad themselves, in their FAQs and guides, if you actually read through these, will say not to modify anything in the browser. Again, this is a privacy browser that is built to keep you safe and keep you looking like everybody else using it. So if you're going around changing settings, you're kind of missing the whole point of the browser. If you want a more customizable version of Mullvad with more flexibility, I would probably take a look at LibreWolf. But if you want something with more privacy, that's where Mullvad's going to excel. And the last point is community, which I think is low to frankly none. This is run by Mullvad, who is a VPN company first, and while they have a passionate following of many people in the privacy community, myself included, who love their work, they don't have many communities for you to join to be involved with other people. This really is kind of a Mullvad project. So if you're looking for a community to surround your browser, you're probably not going to be thrilled with how Mullvad runs things. But this actually is my default browser, as I like my default browser that opens links by default to be private and ephemeral so that it doesn't get linked to all of my other browsing data, and then I have other browsers that I use for different things. And I'll touch more on my personal workflow at the end of the video. The fourth and final Firefox-based alternative to Firefox is the Tor browser. Now, yeah, this is definitely not the best Firefox alternative, but let's at least see how it does stack up in the five focuses. It is open source, and again, kind of like Mullvad browser, very user first, but that user is strictly people chasing privacy and anonymity. Privacy and security, extremely high. Arguably the best. Doesn't really get much better than this. In terms of customization, kind of like Mullvad, none. The only thing you can really do in Tor browser is change the safety toggles from safe to safer to safest. This actually really sucks because Tor doesn't come with an ad blocker out of the box unless you're using it on Tails OS, which is probably not going to be many people who use Tor browser. Fifth and finally is the community, and I'd define it as moderate. While most of the community revolves around the privacy and security of Tor, it's a popular enough browser to have its own dedicated community across areas like Reddit, and they even have training and outreach, and there's whole Onion services that people host to help build up the Tor browser, and there's tons of activists behind it. So ultimately, like, you really are a part of a bigger movement when you use the Tor browser. Now, before we get to the final four non-Firefox-based alternatives, while we're talking about privacy and your online digital footprint, there's another crucial aspect of privacy that often gets overlooked, and it's the data that you're choosing to publish yourself. In Go Incognito 2.4, I showed people how to delete their online identity, and it's notoriously the hardest lesson, as it can take months to do. But the sponsor of this video, Redact.dev, is designed to genuinely make this easy. You can delete your Discord messages, Reddit posts, Twitter posts, and really anything else on most major platforms out there, from Mastodon to Facebook. Redact runs locally on your machine, where they never get your account credentials, so it's only on your system. You can schedule deletions for certain time windows, like I set up my Mastodon feed to delete anything older than a month, so it's kind of an ephemeral feed. You can set rules. My favorite feature is that it will actually archive the data that it deletes locally on your machine if you ask it to. Put simply, instead of manually sifting through years of posts and messages, Redact.dev lets you automate this process. So if you're ready to take control of your online footprint and make deletions, deleting your digital past as simple as just a few clicks, check out Redact.dev. They have a free version and a paid version for those that want to go all in on privacy. Use the link in the description below to get started and support the channel, and they've set up a one-time 10% off code Techlore10, which you can use for their premium and unlimited subscription. Check it out in the description, and now back to the non-Firefox-based alternatives. The first one is Vivaldi. Now, the first point is open source, and this has always been kind of a thing for them because they are source available. You can actually view the code, you can see exactly the code that's running on your system, but the license prevents people from forking it and doing what they want with it. In terms of being user first, I think Look, I'm not a fan of Vivaldi personally. I think it's really powerful and almost too customizable, just to kind of tease some of the focuses that I'm about to talk about. But it is so clearly user first, and I say this because of the community behind it. The people behind it absolutely adore this browser. It's got like the biggest diehard fans who will refuse to use any other browser because they have set it up in a way where it's completely like geared towards them. So I think the point of Vivaldi is honestly to build like just a fully customizable, ultra powerful browser so that anyone can tinker with it in the way they want to. The third thing is privacy and security. I think it's okay. With some tweaks, it's very good. Make sure to opt into their added tracker blocking when you're setting it up for the basics, but I highly recommend using it with uBlock Origin, and I hope that they continue to support it. And there's lots of other things you can tinker with in the setting to make the privacy even stronger. In terms of customization, I don't think it's far-fetched to say it's best on this entire list. Arguably. There isn't a single thing you can't change about Vivaldi. The fifth is the community. And frankly, I also think it's the most passionate community of the whole list. Vivaldi users are diehard. I am like not allowed to say negative things about Vivaldi on this channel without summoning like a wave of pissed off people. Doesn't mean I'm not going to do it because I still don't like Vivaldi personally. I like simple, more minimal browsers that just do the bare minimum. And I think it has kind of this diehard cult following that Firefox used to have. So if you're looking for that strong community in the customization of Firefox and you don't mind using something Chromium based, Vivaldi's a pretty solid option for you to check out. Okay, I have two kind of like offshoot options before I give you a really solid final one. The first one is Ladybird. It's a truly independent web browser. It's not based on Chromium, not based on Firefox, not based on WebKit, which is what Safari uses. They're building their whole new browser engine. Super cool, super ambitious, but we don't really know much about it yet, and you can't even really use it yet. So it is and will be open source in terms of being user first. Too early to tell, but that's obviously the goal, and they are pretty tired of some of the other crap that we're seeing in other browsers. In terms of privacy and security, it's also, in my opinion, too early to tell. Trying to build your own web engine can probably open up a lot of holes, but with that said, they're basing this on Serenity OS, which is a super high bar for security, so this could actually be an insanely secure browser, if not the most secure browser yet, but it's way too early for us to know until we see any kind of public release. In terms of customization, also way too early to call. And in terms of community, this will potentially be really good. They already have 13,000 people on Discord, and I think people are desperate for some alternative to Firefox and Chromium. So if you want to get involved with something fresh and new, but you can't even really use it yet, then check out Ladybird. The second kind of offshoot option before I touch on my final option is Orion. That's how I'm going to say it. I hope I'm saying it correctly. It is not open source, though they claim they're working on it. So it's the only fully proprietary web browser on the list today. Hopefully they change that as they promise. In terms of being user first, I would say yes. It's very fast, very minimal, very battery efficient. It is WebKit based. So you're actually essentially just using Safari, but with a ton of cool features. Like they try to support Chrome and Firefox extensions. Like you can see uBlock Origin here, which notoriously is not on Safari. They also support extensions on mobile. I know that's pretty cool. It has tab groups, and frankly, the way I see it, it's just a better Safari. There's no other way to slice it. Unfortunately, though, it is iOS and macOS only, so you have to kind of be in the Apple ecosystem as of right now. Now, in terms of privacy and security, Orion has no telemetry, which I think is super cool. It does come with a great add-in tracker blocker, and you should be able to use it with uBlock Origin. I wish they had fingerprinting resistance, because I think that would be awesome, and Brave could actually build an equally misleading checklist to make Orion not look good. In terms of customization, it's fairly limited compared to the other options on this list, but so is pretty much anything that's WebKit-based right now. And in terms of community, I'd say it's pretty strong. It's got a nice community of people. People really enjoy both the search engine and Orion. I've actually reviewed Kaji in its own video if you want to check that out to see if paying for a search engine makes any sense. And they've developed a small but definitely mighty community. So it's cool to see kind of those grassroots things come up. So while I don't think this is the best Firefox alternative, I think it's still a worthwhile browser to bring up, especially if you're somebody who's still using Safari for whatever reason. This could be like a direct swap for Safari. And the final browser, which I've kind of already teased when I was talking about Orion, is Brave Browser. Now, Brave is open source, and I would say Brave is like the main competitor to Firefox right now, but it's based on Chromium. In terms of being user first, very polarizing, and I would say, I'm just gonna land in the middle on this and say it's mid. As the largest general competitor to Firefox, they ironically, suffer some similar issues, like their own versions of ads, some bloat out of the box, several scandals, and some people refuse to touch it because it has cryptocurrency stuff. With that said, they also have some insanely cool features, like background YouTube playback on mobile, and a fantastic ad blocker out of the box, and support for uBlock Origin despite Chrome cutting that off. So frankly, I'd say it's a toss-up, with Brave generally being user-first, but not always, and just like totally not doing that sometimes. You're still getting a huge amount of privacy and security coming from something like Chrome. And frankly, in a lot of ways, better than Firefox. It's still not as good as earlier options we talked about, like Mullvad Browser, Tor Browser. But for the usability you're getting with Brave, there are some genuinely good privacy and security benefits that could come from coming like a browser like Chrome that objectively go beyond just marketing. I think that's what they're going for. They're not trying to give you the most private and secure browser out there, and they even put in their documentation to use things like Tor Browser if you need maximum privacy. In terms of customization, I'd say it's mid. Generally, I feel like Brave is less customizable than like Vivaldi, and even in some ways regular Firefox, but you can still do a ton with it that should satisfy most users, especially if you're coming from Chrome. I do think it actually adds cool features and settings that Chrome does not support. And the final thing is community. They have a pretty darn like hardcore passionate community. With that said, there's a lot of like cracks because a lot of things that Brave does is polarizing. Ultimately, I highly recommend you use multiple browsers and see what works best for you, not just to test them, but to actually use them. In my personal life, I use Mullvad, Brave, and Tor, and I think it's a great trio. Mullvad is my default browser, so every link I open is opened in an ephemeral browser that has great privacy, and when I close the browser, it doesn't save or tie that to any of my other traffic. I use Brave for my accounts and things I want to stay logged into and for a more convenient, usable browser. I also have Tor on the side for anything that's really sensitive and that I want the absolute highest amounts of privacy and anonymity for. So I personally have three browsers on my system, and it's something I've been pretty much doing for the last 1 to 2 years at this point. Go ahead and try them all out, see how it fits into your life, and let me know in the comments and share with other people which browsers you have and why you picked those browsers. So try to help other people maybe see what works best for them by sharing your story below. I want to thank Redact.dev for sponsoring this video. It's truly a great service to help you clean up your online presence. And I especially want to thank our patrons who are directly supporting what we do here at Techlore and producing this kind of content for all of you. And we also have a private signal group you can join if you are on Patreon. So check that all out down in the description. And if you want to learn how to be private on a budget, literally from $0 a month all the way up to $13 a month, I go through all the different scenarios of how to achieve that in this video that you'll see here. How to stay private on a budget, go check that out, and I'll see you next time on Techlore.